Hello! Welcome to this how-to video. My name is Andrea Schumann. I'm a support architect for SAP Cloud ALM. In this video, I will demonstrate how to set up integration and exception monitoring in SAP Cloud ALM for SAP Sales and Services Cloud. I will show you how to create a communication system and a communication arrangement in SAP Sales and Services Cloud, how to create an endpoint in SAP Cloud ALM, and how to activate the monitoring data collection. To activate integration monitoring in SAP Sales and Services Cloud, you have to create a communication arrangement which can be used by SAP Cloud ALM to connect to SAP Sales and Services Cloud. Log on to your SAP Sales and Services Cloud tenant. The first step is to create a new communication system. Navigate to Administrator, General Settings. Scroll to Integration. Click on Communication Systems. Click the New button to create a new communication system. Enter a system ID. As hostname, enter the endpoint URL for your SAP Cloud ALM tenant. You find it in your SAP Cloud ALM service key as value of the parameter API, or in the URL of your SAP Cloud ALM tenant. As System Access Type, select Internet. Scroll down to System Instances. Click the Add Row button. Enter a name for the System Instance ID. As Preferred Application Protocol, select 5 Web Service. Click the Save and Close button to save your communication system. Under All Communication Systems, click the Refresh button. Select your communication system from the list. Click Actions, Set to Active. Go back to General Settings. The next step is to create a communication arrangement that uses this communication system. Under Integration, click on Communication Arrangements. In the column Communication Scenario, filter for Web. If you already find an arrangement with the communication scenario, query Web Service Message for monitoring. Please note that you can only create one communication arrangement with this scenario. You can reuse this communication arrangement for your SAP Cloud ALM connection, but need to find out the username and password for the communication user used in this arrangement. To create a new communication arrangement, click the New button. In the step Select Scenario, search for Web in the column Communication Scenario. Select the scenario, query Web Service Message for monitoring. Click the Next button. In the step Define Business Data, enter the ID of your communication system instance in the field System Instance ID. Press the Enter key. Click the Next button. In the step Define Technical Data, click the Edit Credentials button. The user ID displayed here will be created automatically and cannot be changed. Enter the password that you want to use for this user under Change Password. Press the OK button. Click the Next button. In the step Review, you find a summary of your inputs. Click the Finish button. Close your new communication arrangement. Click the Refresh button to display your new communication arrangement in the list. This concludes the setup steps in SAP Sales and Services Cloud. Now we get to the setup in SAP Cloud ALM. Log on to your SAP Cloud ALM tenant. Make sure that you have the authorization, Integration Monitoring Integration Architect to be able to perform the necessary setup steps. The first step is to create an endpoint to the SAP Sales and Services Cloud tenant in Landscape Management. You find the Landscape Management app in the group Administration. Open the Landscape Management app. Your SAP Sales and Services Cloud tenant should already be available in the Landscape Management, as it is automatically imported from the System Landscape Information Service at SAP. Click on the Name or the Details button for the cloud service. On the tab Endpoints, click the Add button to add a new endpoint. Enter an endpoint name and a description. Select Integration Monitoring as use case for this endpoint. The root URL is automatically copied from the cloud service information in the Landscape Management. Select Basic Authentication as authentication type. Enter the username and the password for the user in the communication arrangement created in SAP Sales and Services Cloud. You can use the Check Connection button to see if your connection works. Save your endpoint. This concludes the activities in Landscape Management. The last step is to activate the data collection for integration and exception monitoring for the SAP Sales and Services Cloud service. You find the integration and exception monitoring application in the group SAP Cloud ALM for Operations. Open Integration and Exception Monitoring. To be able to perform the configuration, the cloud service needs to be in scope for Integration and Exception Monitoring. Open the scope selection. Make sure Display Service contains all. Add your SAP Sales and Services Cloud service to the selection. Click the Apply button. Now open the configuration panel using the recwheel icon in the upper right corner. In the services tray, you find your SAP Sales and Services Cloud service. Activate the data collection by sliding the lever from off to on. This concludes the standard setup for integration and exception monitoring. Thank you for watching this video. You now know how to set up integration and exception monitoring for SAP Sales and Services Cloud with SAP Cloud ALM. For further information regarding the technical setup, feel free to consult the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Expert Portal, which is continuously updated with the latest news. A link to the Expert Portal is provided in the description of this video.